Hi, this is George from Shirley Diaries. The following tutorial will be a quick introduction to Thea for Rhino. After having installed and activated the plugin, the first thing you should do is to set Thea Render as the current renderer. To do so, go to the Render menu and select Thea for Rhino. By opening Rhino, you will have access to Thea from the drop-down menu and the toolbar. Let's have a look at the drop-down first. We have Viewport Render, Darkroom, Render Settings, Import and Export options for Thea Models, Environment and Render Settings. The last two options allow you to update and activate your plugin. Let's move on now to the next part and take a look at the toolbar. The first group of icons have to do with Viewport Render. We can start, stop and save the image displayed on the viewport. Let's press start and see that we have the interactive render inside Rhino viewport and we can navigate our scene as we would in Rhino. We can rotate the scene, pan and zoom. The next button is Thea Darkroom, and from here we can switch between interactive and production mode and also choose their corresponding render engines. The icons to the right control the interactive viewport inside Darkroom. We can place the focal point, rotate, pan, zoom and tilt the viewport. The last icon, the Eyedropper Tool, allows you to eyedrop on an object and get its Thea material. At the bottom we have Save Image button, the Refresh Image which refreshes the interactive viewport when changes have been made in the display settings, and of course, the Start, Pause and Stop buttons. Let's have a look at the next icon that brings up Thea render settings. This panel has three tabs, the rendering, that has all the available rendering parameters. The environment, from where we can modify the physical sky and enable image-based lighting. From the camera tab we can change the resolution, lens, depth of field and Z-clipping. It is best to have this DAP dock to the right, so you can have quick access to it. The next icon creates a new Thea material and brings up the material tab, with the new material created and selected. You could also dock the materials tab next to the render settings. The next icon brings up sun and sky tab, from where you can enable the physical sky and the ground plane. The last seven icons import and export Thea models, environment and render settings. After having explained Thea Toolbar, we can get on with creating Thea materials. Rhino materials are being supported natively by Thea, but it is recommended to use Thea materials as they are more advanced and physically based. In order to create a new Thea material, you have to press the plus icon in the Material tab and select Thea material. Now you have two options to select from. From the Material preset drop-down, you can select the type of the material you would like to create. For this example, we will select the plastic type and change its color to black and apply it to the scene. The other way is by pressing the Open Browser button, which opens Thea Content Browser. The materials displayed here are in categories and are installed by default. For this example, we will create the rest of the materials that we have created for this scene. Let's start the viewport render and have a look at the final image. As you can see, Thea for Rhino is a very powerful product with advanced features and an easy to learn workflow. Feel free to download the scene that we have prepared for this tutorial at the description below. You could also visit our website to find more information. Thank you all for watching.